So, good morning. Today is the day after yesterday, and what better reason to do a paint pour? As you can see, this is going to be a do-over. And I think this is the third do-over I'm going to do. So whether that's one too many do-overs or not on the canvas, I don't know, but we're going to find out. And I got some, I think they're kind of pretty colors. They're a little muted, but I think they're pretty. I'm going to do three open cups, a big fatty, and two little satellite cups. And we'll see what we can come up with. This is another adventure in trying something new, which is part of the fun of paint pouring. So I'll get this set up, put the white base down, and I will be back. Okay, here we're back. And we're back for the pour. Hey, that's a good one. Okay. I am going to put a little bit there, and like I said earlier, this is an experiment. Which should be fun, because all experiments are fun until they blow up in your face. I don't know why I like this style. I guess it's because I really never know how it's going to end up. I like the Dutch pours too. They're fun because you get to use the hurricane blower. Okay, I am going to add these colors in no specific order. Whatever suits my fancy. It may take me a few minutes to figure it out. And then, of course, I'll put my gloves on and we'll do a tip and slide. So bear with me. I will zip my lips and we can fast forward through this while I'm pouring these in here. So here we go. Well, I'm back, and we're looking good here, aren't we? Well, I think I'll put my gloves on. The generic gloves. Remember those from last time? You look in the box for hours trying to find the left and the right-hand gloves. None of them are labeled. Aggravating. You know I'm teasing, right? Okay, like I said, this is an experiment. So I'm going to experiment doing this. Here's one. There's two. And there's three. And I'm going to have to move these out of the way because I will get paint all over them. And we don't want to have that mess to contend with. Fun part is getting the little tabs back on the right color bottles so you don't contaminate the little nipples. And I think I'm doing it right. Here we go. I don't know why I'm in a hurry. It's not like the paint's going to dry on me in 20 seconds. This looks interesting, doesn't it? Yes, it does. remember, this is, I guess we'd call it the Phoenix, because it's rising up out of the ashes of a couple of paintings that I think the professional term is they sucked. So here we go. Okay, whoops, get this out of the way. One more to do. Here we are. Now, let's do some slip and slide. Well, I think the color combinations, I'm going to say they're a little southwestern. I think with I would have to say, being into the first few moments of this, I don't find it offensive. That's a good sign, isn't it? Oh yeah. Ooh. I think I'm liking this. Let's get some up in the other corner up here. Ooh, look at that run. It's running like my nose does some mornings. I need some Flonase. I don't know if you can see that. I'll bring it back your way. I think I want to come down a little. Well, I don't think this will get me thrown out of the Academy of Fine Arts. But I'm going to have to say I do find it fun. Yeah. Let's bring it back to the center. I think I want to take a little bit over to this corner here. Richard, that's not a corner, that's an edge. Okay, let's go back to basic geometry, pal. There we go. Isn't this the turquoise and the browns are really quite fun? I'm liking this. As well as I should. Let's don't get it too muddy. Okay, I'm going to set that right back down there. And there's a chunk. I don't know where the chunks come from. And I'm going to get rid of, I am going to take off, well, make up your mind and do one thing or the other, Richard. I want to put some more white down here, and I want to get rid of that red. So I'm going to take my gloves off, and these will be the last time there it goes, flying stuff on my chair. I'm telling you, my wife is going to have a field day with me when she sees this mess. Okay, I'm going to scrape this off. Just like that, just like they do in the circus after the elephants. And I think I'll get rid of that little hooger there. Look at this, spatula man. Okay, let's get out the white, take the lid off. And let's go along here. I think this maybe has some good potential. Yeah, yeah. Yep, a little over here. And for those of you who enjoy watching my finger painting session, I'll get my fingers at the ready here. Yep, yep, yep. Looking good. Okay, let's come around and look at the front. Actually, I think we'll just call it the top. Okay. That's kind of like the Navajo Nation colors to me anyway. A little Red Rock Canyon, a little turquoise. And I can't believe I'm saying this, but I don't think I'm going to get out my mini blower. Oh, be darn. Will you look at that? How about the... let's get out the blowtorch. I didn't get very much lacing. Well, I got a little bit of lacing. Not very many bubbles. In fact, I don't really see any bubbles. And I don't see any gorilla hair like from the last one I did. I strained my my Floetrol. I used to strain the whole gallon at once, so I had it all ready to go. And then I think even sitting there after it was been strained, it would get goobers in there. And no matter what I did, the goobers would end up coming out. So what I've done now is I just take my piece of nylon and throw it over the top of the gallon ones and just fill up a quart of Floetrol at a time, and that seems to have eliminated the goobers that get in there. So with that, I'm going to turn this off and look at it a little bit, probably fiddle as most people like to fiddle with these, and then I will be back momentarily or shortly, whichever comes first. Okie dokie, so there you have it. I think I can zoom in a little bit. Well, I can zoom in, but how well it looks is a different matter. Yeah, it's better if I zoom, take it out of this tripod and zoom in from the front, which I think I will do. But I really didn't manipulate this too much. I just let it be what it is. I didn't use any blowers on it. I didn't use my straw. I didn't use my number two pencil. Wow, either I'm getting better or it's so bad that I didn't notice what it looks like. Oh, for heaven's sake, what a great pour. Anyway, I'll turn this off and we'll go to the front of the work table here and we'll take a close up. We'll be right back. I'll tell you, with this new camera, I've got a choice of 0.5, 1 times or 2 times the photo lens, and 0.5 is too small. I'm on 1 times, and it's a good thing I'm 6'4". I wouldn't be able to stand up this tall and still see the camera and the picture. So I will just bring this in slowly and slowly, easy as she goes, Captain. Yeah, I think these colors are really kind of cool. It is Southwest. I'm definitely calling this a Southwest piece. What do you call it? New Mexico, Arizona, something like that. Very nice. Sure, you'd say that. You did it. Okay, I'm going to cut this off here. I'll take a few photos of it. And we're going to call this a pretty fun pour today. I have another do-over to do in the next couple of days. It's that black on the black background. So I'll be laying those paints out for that one next. But in the meantime, I enjoyed this. I hope you had fun watching it with me and thinking positive thoughts. So until next time, this is Richard B. saying goodbye.